Today we're going to talk about how to deal with configurations that you may or may not know. So one of the issues that occurs a lot is people ask, how do I configure, let's say, the BL touch or, you know, the steppers, and I haven't covered the tutorial yet. So I'm going to show you a trick on how you can figure out what a configuration is with a couple of different simple tools. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to show you on the desktop of the computer what we can do. So if we were to go and download our firmware from the most current build, we could actually decipher what the firmware is for the configuration that we may want. Now, this doesn't cover everything, but it will show you how to figure it out. So what I'm going to do is download the actual configuration. So I'm on the configuration portion. I'm going to click download zip, and this will pull it to my computer. Next thing that I'll do is I'll actually have to extract it. So if we go over to the downloads folder, when it finally arrives, what we can do is we can right click on it. We can then go to extract all, then we'll extract it. And once this is extracted, we can pick out, for example, say you have a Creality Ender 3 Pro and you have a specific board, or maybe not a specific board, but you want to know what the configuration may look like. This is what we can do to figure it out. So there's a couple of methods I'm going to show you. There's probably several more that are actually cheaper or free, but let me show you this one real quick. So I'm going to open up, first of all, the folder for configurations. So there are example configurations in here. These are not static configurations for your configuration. They vary between printers, so I have to emphasize that. So let's go to Creality. We'll find the Ender 3 Pro right here. And then you can see that there's an SKR 1.4 Turbo, but there's not the SKR version 3 that we're working with, but a lot of this configuration will be close to what we're working with. So I'm going to click here, and as you can see, it's got several things in here: a boot screen, a status screen, configuration.h, and configuration advanced.h. So I'm going to copy these two, and I'm going to copy them to a folder. Let's see, over in here, we'll call it compare. And let's see what we can do. So inside here, I'm going to paste these files, and I'm going to have to rename them because we're going to be comparing two similar file names. So I'll click here and I'll do underscore SKR. So that's configuration SKR.h. And this one we'll rename to underscore SKR for the advanced. So now that we've got those, we need to get our default configuration. So this one I'm not sure about because it may be stale. So I'm going to delete that. I'm going to extract a brand new configuration that's unmodified. So I'll extract all on this. This may take a few seconds to actually extract. So one of the things I want to show you first is that you can actually add a plugin over in here, or extension. So if you click here and you type, let's try compare. And I tried out one of these last night that I kind of liked. So I think it's compare folders. So I'm going to do install, and this will install it into my environment. So now what I can do is actually show you how to use it. But first things first, I'm going to go back and show you another method to do this in just a second. So let me minimize this and see where we are. Looks like we're almost done. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the extracted files that we have from Marlin over here, and we're going to use these to compare. So we'll go back over to the downloads folder, go to the compare folder, and we know that these are the known good configurations for H on configuration.h. So I'm going to highlight both, and I have a software called Beyond Compare. Now you can get a trial version of this and use it, or you can buy it. I'm not going to try and sell you on it. I just want to show you it. So inside here, I'll click compare. And one of the cool things about this is you can see what all the same things are in the file. You can see the whole file. So you can see there's differences already, or you can see just the diffs. So this will pull out the entire configuration for your particular configuration. So if you look at this kind of closely, you can see that there's custom screens. One is, they're both commented out, so we're gonna ignore that, but we can see what the actual serial port configuration is for the first serial port, and that there's a second serial port in the SKR configuration. So this may give us clues as to how we can set things up over in here compared to the known default configuration. Notice how over in here, if you look at the two lines, you can see that there's the BigTreeTech SKR and then the RAMP's default configuration. So all of this is pretty much simplified for you, so you can find what the configuration is for your setup. So essentially, the bed size will depend on if it's an actual Creality Ender 3 Pro, but you can see what everything is and you can configure it. And this will give you a good handbook as to what you're doing. Now, normally I add them in one at a time so that I can check each piece as I go along, because there will be differences between the example configuration, because it's called example, and the actual. So one of the cool things about this is if you want to actually copy things over to your regular config file, what you can do is you can actually go through here and you can find the settings, and you see this little arrow, you can click it to actually change it, and then you can save it out. Now, there was an export function in here years ago where you could export out the differences, but apparently you just need to basically cut and paste all of this into Notepad, and that'll do the exact same thing. So if you want an actual list of what's different, you can highlight the entire side here, right click, copy it. And another software that you can use is actually Notepad++. There we go. And this will do compares as well by adding a plugin. It's up in here, so you can find like the compare plugin and add it. So I'm not going to go in too much detail with this, but it's a free software that you can use to do it as well. So I'm going to close out of here, and I'll show you the last method to do this. So inside of here, we want to open up our folder. So I'm going to do it this way this time. So open folder, go to my downloads folder, go to the Marlin folder, and then select the folder. Now, obviously there's nothing here yet to compare. If we look inside of the Marlin folder, we only have these two. So what we want to do is we'll go over to our downloads folder. We'll go to the compare folder to cheat quick. We'll copy both of these. Then we'll go back over to the downloads folder, the Marlin folder, again, and then this folder, we'll paste them right here. So I'll show you what happens inside of VS Code. So in VS Code, we now have two of each. Now you're gonna delete these when you're done, but what you can do is, for example, you can highlight both with the control button or the shift button, depending upon how you do it, right click, and then there should be a function for compare selected. Now you can see that there's a difference, and you see there's a little arrow. So if you wanna actually copy over to, as you can see up here, this is the SKR configuration, and this is your configuration, big configuration.h. So if you wanted to say, okay, I want this, you can just click the arrow. So obviously this will speed up for a lot of you how you're going to set up your device. In this case, we're going to click this to bring over our configuration, but obviously it's not for the SKR version 3. So you will have to look it up like normal by going source, core, boards.h, search on SKR underscore V3, and this will bring you to your actual configuration, pardon me. So you can just copy that out, and then you can close it, go back over here, and actually paste it here if you want. And that will set up your configuration for configuration.h. Once you're done, what you want to do before you build is delete this and this from your configuration. Obviously, your platform io.ini will have to change like normal, where you have to go search for your configuration. So that's going to be in the ini file. So if you click over here, you're going to have to find your board. But to find it, a little clue, besides the actual MCU on the top of your motherboard, is to go to boards.h. And over here, you can see what the chipset is. Now, keep in mind that they have a habit at BigTreeTech of adding new processors. So if this is not up to date, what you'll have to do is update it. So one of the tricks you can use is to actually check to see if it's something different on their website. But currently, it looks like they have one chipset listed here. So it's STM32H743. So we'll minimize this. We'll go over here and we'll find STM32F7, click on it, and then we'll search on SKR underscore V3, hopefully. And it's not showing up, so let's do SKR. So apparently I might be in the wrong folder, so let's go back and double check. So source core boards.h, STM32H7. So the folder that we're in is going to have to be H7. So I was probably in the wrong folder. So SKR underscore V3. And as you can see, there's a couple of versions in here. So as you can see right here, that's our board. So I'll highlight this, right click, copy, and then I'll minimize this source and I'll find my platform IO. Replace my processor, and we're good there. So I'm gonna knock these out for the moment. So I'm gonna close this. I'll show you where the changes are, hopefully, if they worked. So we'll delete, we'll move it to the recycling bin. We'll delete, move it to the recycling bin. And then we'll double check to see what our actual board is. And it's correct. So it already copied it over. So what we can do is we can try and build it by clicking the checkbox over here. And the configuration that we copied over may have an issue, as it looks like right here. So let's see what we got here. It says unknown motherboard in your configuration. So there's obviously an error that I missed. So I can show you, first of all, the reason it's unknown is because it's got an extra B. So let's try this again. But before we do that, we do have to change this to -1 because it's a 32-bit board. And you can pick that out with your comparison that I showed you over in here. So if we were to go down through here, we could actually find what it is. So you can see it's right here for the SKR configuration. And over here, it's 0. So now let's try building this again. And at this moment, if you do have issues when it's building, remember, sometimes things build out of order. It's less likely now than it was in the past. So you can always do a second build. If there is an issue where you see red like we just saw earlier, what you can do is go to the very first error. And you can even highlight it by hitting the control button on your keyboard and then clicking on it, and it may give you more information as to what you see. But usually the errors are pretty clear If not, there's also a Discord that I'll leave a link to in the description for your convenience, where you can talk to people in general chat that actually have a similar or possible understanding of what the issue may be. Also, you can do a file compare, like I just showed you, to see if you can narrow down what the error may be. So at this moment, I'd like to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Please like and subscribe. And as always, I will place a thank you note at the end of the video for both the patrons and the people on PayPal that donate to this channel. So everyone take care, be safe, and remember to like and subscribe.